In this tutorial, I'm showing you exactly how you can create any brushes for any situation that you may need. Hey guys, today I want to show you how I create my own brushes. Sometimes when I create illustration, I need some custom brushes to do certain parts of it. Like on this case for the hair, I needed some particular brushes to help me creating my hair. I wanted to have a special texturized hair. So I created three brushes. This is how I created them. To help me create all the brushes that I needed, I created myself a sheet of 100 brush tip. They're all high res, and all those brush tips can be used to do all sorts of things. I separated them into four categories: texture, fades, particles, and marks. And each of those categories can do something different. You can mix them, mix and max, to do all sorts of brushes. And each time that I need a brush, I go back to this. I use a few tips, I mix them, I create a brush, and therefore I'm able to accomplish the task that I need. So the way it works, I have this sheet with all the brushes in front of me from 1 to 100, so I can decide which one I want. And then I have another document, this one, where I actually have in high res the brushes, and therefore they have the same number, so I can just pick one. And at this point, the only thing that I have to do is, once I chose my brush tip, I go over edit, I do define brush preset, click on it, I give it the name that I want. Usually I give them the name of the texture, if it's texture or fade or particle. In this case is texture 49, so I'm gonna call it T49, press OK, and then Photoshop puts it automatically into my brushes at the end. So this is the last one, this is the T49. And then I can go back to my illustration, select the brush that I want. So let's say I would select this one, for instance, and then open the brush panel that you can find over here, over window. You simply have to say brush. It's gonna open that panel. And then I do the changes that I need to create the brush. So I wanna show you the three brushes that I created for my hair. I'm not gonna go too many in too much detail here. I'm just gonna show you exactly what I did. I won't explain it, but I'll make sure at the end of the video to give you a link where you can download the 100 brush tips, as well as where to find the information on how to create your own brushes, so all the details of the brush panel, basically. I'll tell you that a little bit later, but for now, so I created three brushes. The first one, I needed something big enough to create the bulk hair, the big parts of my hair. So I created this brush here, which I used two tips for this. And so if we go like more in details into the brush, you can see that the brush tip that I used was the T16, so the texture 16. So that was the first thing that I did. I saved the T16 as my brush. Then I added a little bit of shape dynamic. I added a texture. Usually I use the texture that Photoshop gives us. They have a multitude of texture. You simply have to click on the arrow, click on the icon here, and you can choose between all those textures here. Then I added another tip from the 100 tip that I showed you previously to this one. This one was the T39. And then I added a little bit of transfer, making sure that I would see both of the dual brush and the texture when I paint. So I used that to create the first part of my hair. And then I used another one, this one here, to create some smaller hair. So all the smaller hair that comes on top, as much as the highlights, because I needed something to bring the highlights of the hair. So I created this one, and for this one I use only one tip. So sometimes you use one, sometimes I use two, depending on what I need. And finally, I use this third one here because I needed something with a little bit more texture to create the hair at the back of the head, because she's actually shaved. So for that, I created something with a little bit more texture. On this one, I used two brush tips. I first use one of the fade. I use the fade 58. And using a fade brush like this one is giving me the possibility to have that kind of effect right now. So it's like a little bit like it's spraying the paint. And then I used some shape dynamic, some scattering, also a little bit of texture. So I use, once again, the texture that Photoshop gives us. The dual brush, in this case, the second brush was the P72, and a little bit of transfer to make sure that I see both the dual brush and the texture when I'm painting. Also, one thing that is super important when you create brushes, make sure that once you finish doing all your setting of your brush and you like it, to go back to your brush panel and click on the new brush preset. Because if you don't save the brush that you just created, it's going to go back to the actual brush tips and you'll lose all the modification that you've done. So just remember to do that whenever you finish one brush. So this is how you can create many brushes with those 100 brush tips. You can use all those tips to create so many brushes. And the reason they're separate in texture, fade, particle, and marks is because texture will be good for, let's say, oil brushes or pastel brushes. Fades will give you a little bit more of a feel of ink brushes or maybe watercolor brushes. And the marks and particles can be used for a lot of things, from hair brushes to simply texturized brushes and many more. And since I started to use those, I found myself creating all sorts of brushes, and I wanted to make sure that I could give you the opportunity to do the same. So I'm going to put a link below this video where you can download these 100 brush tips, as well as where to find the information on how to create professional brushes. And from there, I think that you'll be equipped to create all sorts of kind of brushes that you may need. Whatever, if it's just for hair, or if you want to create some watercolor brushes, so oil brushes, I'll put all the information that you need in that link. And that's it for this tutorial, guys. Don't forget to like, share, or comment below this video. And if you really want to take your digital painting to the next level, come check out the Academy, where we offer in-depth tutorial, step-by-step lessons, exercises, live workshops, premium resources, and a world-class community of inspired digital painters like yourself, ready to help you and support whenever you need it. You just have to click on the link below this video or on the button to find more. And until next time, happy painting.